So the notion that Rob doesn't know the cap was never anywhere. It was never anywhere on my timeline or my writing, because you have to know your history, right? Mm-hmm. Rob Pelinka was a longtime agent, and he represented Derek Fisher. Derek Fisher was the head of the union when we had the 2011 lockout. And so as that CBA was negotiated, a lot of it was done out of Rob Pelinka's office, which is in Orange County, with Fisher. So and obviously Derek probably now has a greater, he hasn't been participating in it, but at the time had grown to fully understand all these sides, but and the depth of the CBA. But leading up to it, he needed to rely on Rob a lot for that. So Rob had a big hand in resolving that 2011 lockout.
What we gonna do right here is go back, way back.
The glaringly obvious fix right here, right now, is for Jeannie Buss today to fire Rob Pelinka.
Somebody lying, or some version is false.
Well, let's keep Stephen this A, we heard about who lies. And, among these characters, the reporting has been that Pelinka has the reputation of a liar. That's what the reporting has been. So if you're saying someone has lied, and one guy is notorious for it and the other is not, then you can draw your own conclusion.
Rob Pelinka was an agent. Rob Pelinka was not a scout. He was not a personnel man. He was not in the business of the organization. He was an agent. He happened to be Kobe Bryant's agent. Does this sound like a man that probably ignored the salary cap ramifications or didn't know? Yeah, that does sound like that type of guy. Yes, Pelinka does seem like that type of guy.
Well, it's also unnecessary, too. I mean, the way this trade was constructed, like, this should have been first and foremost on their minds as they were talking to the Pelicans in a way where they set themselves up. If this was really their plan, they want to have a third star. This should have been central to the conversations with the Pelicans, and my understanding is that it was not. That
why
went
was
all
it
the way down the road, and it was it's been described to me as the Lakers called back after everything had been discussed, like, about this.
After the initial deal was put together.
And so, to me, if this was important to you, this should have been something you were arguing for in the deal construction to begin with. To do this now, you've lost all your leverage. You put yourself in a bad spot with any of these trades. You may have to incentivize teams to take on players like Mo Wagner. Correct. I mean, the key word in Woj's report yesterday was scrambling. Scrambling means you weren't ahead of this.
You weren't ready.
So when you're scrambling, you're probably not going to make the best decisions or the best deals.
Crazy day. What would I do if I'm the Lakers?
Yes,
I'll tell you what I would do right now. I would fire Rob Pelinka today.
Wow.
Now, what I would have done is fire Rob Pelinka earlier.
After Magic quit and then explained himself. Because you know he talked about this with Jeannie Buss when he went to lunch or whatever, dinner, whatever it is that picture was.
I think it was dinner.
It was out there.
He can't be there. He is not. To win in the NBA, you've got to have relationships. Mm-hmm. And relationships are built on trust.
Yeah.
And right now, the person who is probably least trustworthy in the NBA with any sort of hammer or juice card is Rob Pelinka.
Yeah.
So if you're a free agent, you trusted him? Nope.
Hey, Rob, congrats. Last June, you pull off the trade to acquire Anthony, and you have LeBron and Anthony, and that's a heck of a head start, but there's so much that needs to be done to get to this point. What was it like having the benefit of having those two great players, but then having the pressure of making sure you do whatever you do to surround them in the right way to get to here?
You know, it's interesting. A lot of people think that trades are easy in the NBA. If you talk to any of the other 29 GMs, and there's some really, really good ones that I get to work alongside of, any trade, especially for a superstar, is incredibly difficult and challenging, filled with intricacies and issues that the general public might never really understand. But dynamics of pulling off superstar trades are very, very challenging. And so when they take weeks of hard work, and we were thankful when we acquired Anthony, but we knew the work wasn't done once we paired LeBron and AD together. And last season, of course, we had cap space to add another max player. But we went into that with, and Kobe was such a great mentor of me in terms of, he always talked about his counters. You know, like in 1 year, maybe he would dominate with, you know, a fadeaway. And so then the next year he'd come back and teams would say, hey, we have to take away his fadeaway, so he'd work on a spin move and attack the rim. So it was always about counters. And so in free agency last year, we had, obviously, we made a run to acquire a max free agent, but we had a counter. We had a backup plan, and I knew we had a way to pivot and build the team with the other players we were able to acquire, and it worked out well, obviously. But it was hard work. It wasn't just happenstance, like, oh, let's go sign a bunch of guys. Our front office, I can't take credit, because we have a front office of a lot of incredibly hardworking, bright people in our basketball operations department, and it takes a village to have success, and all those people helping with that plan, it came together, and here we are. We're, you know, the ultimate with a 2020 championship.
The last time they all came together was back in January, and it was in profound sadness with the loss of Kobe Bryant, his daughter, and those seven others. But tonight, the Laker fans can unite in joy as they celebrate a title. Under a minute remaining. And what a way to close out this championship season. As you see, Davis and James, it's all coming out. And one of the great pleasures of this job every year is watching they become little kids again. When that title is realized, when it's finally over, and all the work, all the sweat, all the practices, all the travel, and in this case, all this time in the bubble, ends up with what they all set out for as their number one and only goal.
You know what? Each guy invested, and LeBron is thinking, I promised this guy this. I told him that things would be different. And to finish it off, they all should be extremely proud.
Well, Linick puts it up at him. Caruso will bring it up. LeBron James already celebrating. I'm sure they are back in Los Angeles again. Dwight Howard knocks down a three-pointer. There's the exclamation point, and the Heat will just bring it up. The Lakers will win game six. And now Cook can just dribble it out.
And J.R. Smith already shirtless.
Final seconds here in this NBA season. The respect from those two. And that's it. It's over. This historic 2020 NBA championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers. The Lakers conquer the bubble, and banner number 17 will soon hang in the rafters.